In this video presentation, I am going to show you how to use the t-test and t-interval functions on the TI-83 calculator to analyze the difference between two means with dependent samples. So let's explore an example. A dietitian develops a new weight loss program. To determine the effectiveness of the program, he selects 6 patients to participate in the study. He measures their weight before the program. 10 weeks later, he measures their weights again. The data is listed as follows. At the 5% level of significance, is there enough evidence to suggest that the mean weight of the patients was significantly greater before participating in the 10-week weight loss program? Also, construct a 90% confidence interval for the difference between two means. Since we're analyzing the difference between two means with dependent samples, we'll need to find the differences first. Once we find the differences, we can then enter them into a list. So I'm going to press stat and select number 1 for edit so I can enter the differences into a list. Recall that the researcher wanted to determine if the mean weight of the patients was significantly greater before participating in the 10-week weight loss program. Therefore, the direction of the alternative hypothesis is going to be greater than. As a result, the weight before the program is going to be group 1. So we'll need to subtract our differences by taking group 1 minus group 2. And so if we take group 1 minus group 2, the first difference is 7. The second difference is 4, and so forth. And basically, you're just going to enter in the differences into a list. Once all of the differences are entered into a list, you're then going to press stat, use the right arrow key to highlight tests, and select number 2 for a t-test. Since we have the data entered into a list, I'm going to make sure that data is highlighted. The null hypothesis for this example is 0, and my list is in L1. If you enter your data into another list, you'd simply press the second key and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 to represent the list that you entered the data. Frequency is always set to 1, and the alternative hypothesis is greater than, which is the third option. So going to the third option and pressing enter will highlight greater than. Go down to calculate, press enter, and you'll see the value of the test statistic as well as the p-value. Since the p-value is not less than alpha, then we're not able to reject the null hypothesis. Now we're going to use the t-interval function on the calculator to construct a confidence interval. So once again, we're going to press stat, use the right arrow key to highlight tests, and scroll down until we see t-interval. Again, since I have the actual data, I want to make sure that data is highlighted. My data was placed into L1, frequency is always set to 1, and my confidence level is 0.90. Next, I'm going to highlight calculate and press enter, and you'll see the values of the confidence interval.